don't think marriage means anything to me. If you want to, if I can say it in, you know, just being blunt about it, you know, marriage doesn't mean nothing to me. It's like, it's a waste of money at a wedding. It's now you got to figure out like, oh yeah, now I got to spend the rest of my life with this person. And it's like, what if, you know, 20 years from now, you want to date somebody else, but now you're like married. So now you got to go and get rid of that piece of paper. And it's like, I don't want to be with you no more. A couple of forever. What up, y'all? It's your girl Ashley.
It's your boy Ricky.
And we are
the Raphaels.
So we are doing a mukbang because I've cooked all this food. I cooked the macaroni al goite. I cooked the cornbread. I cooked the stewed chicken and the sauce, the bunun, and I also cooked. This is called Diajonjon,
right?
Yes. And then over here, I cooked white rice, legging, and bunun. Can you cut your phone on silent?
It's plantain, y'all.
Plantain. And then also we have
bean sauce,
but we got the brown one. So I cooked all this food because he asked for a Haitian meal.
Yeah, since we did a 21-day fast, you know, today the fast is officially over with. So, I mean,
I prepared this good feast for me. Boo, you gonna go along with the lie? I didn't cook it.
Yeah. Exactly.
We got this from Kieski Bon, but I did cook the macaroni. All right,
And the cornbread.
Okay, so we about to say a prayer and eat.
Bless your Father, bless and thank you, Lord, for the food, Father God. Bless this food, Father God. Let it nourish our bodies and let it pray, Lord. Amen.
Amen. And if y'all hear somebody,
Kobe.
It's Roxy. Yep. She's greedy, bro. Kobe. She's bad. I don't know what happened lately, but I'ma dive into this cornbread first.
Alright, I'm gonna probably go dive into this legume.
Let me taste it.
Let me get that spoon.
I didn't bring nothing to cut cornbread. And then the macaroni. Ooh. I tasted that already. It's super good. Roxy, stop it now. You putting on for the city. The people gonna think we on Fiji.
We go add that sauce spot to it. From that point, you add that legging.
Yeah, I eat the legging. But he got beef and he normally just get the eggplant one, so I don't know what he was doing. I love the buttons. I like Haitian plantain better than I'm gonna give her a hard piece of plantain so she
like
can
a golden eat. Crust.
You want yeah, in Jamaica. Let me reach and get this one. I'm gonna put my leg in. Did you show the people?
I'm sorry, I was just
on top of my Diri Cola. I mean,
see, that's how you do it. You put the rice, you put the bean sauce over it, then you put the legging.
But what about over top of the Diajonjon?
Diajonjon, you just put the sauce.
The sauce in here?
Yeah, say some of that mac and cheese. Put some sauce on that mac and cheese on it.
No, you do yours like that, boo. Did you even get cornbread?
What?
It's good over top of the black rice.
Yeah. It's real good.
So y'all, I know we've been MIA, but Ricky actually
I made a request to, you know, do a mukbang since we haven't done one in a long time. And, you know, we haven't been eating, you know, junk food. We've just been on a 21-day dang fast. So now that today's over with, you know, I mean, now that the fast is over with, you know, I asked baby to, you know, cook some Haitian mac and cheese and the cornbread. We picked up the, you know, the G.I. Donjon and the food. We picked up the G.I. Donjon and the sauce pool and the legume and rice. And so that's why yesterday I had kids keep on. So these two pans we bought, these two pans were made. Mm-hmm. You know, so easier to tell. But besides that, I mean, actually, yeah, yes, it tastes. It tastes real good. I'm gonna give y'all a little bite of that.
I'm drinking the sparkling water.
There you go.
Key lime.
Lovely.
Mm. The key lime one, I don't care what flavor, honestly. I drink them all. But I don't want to go back to drinking juices and stuff like that because they got a lot of calories. I'd rather eat my calories than drink them. I couldn't believe she had that hard piece of plantain.
Man, I want you not get no more.
Oh, shoot.
Don't, no, don't give them no more.
Just a little piece of chicken.
No. One piece. Go ahead. But she just ate. I got you. Finish your food.
So, the reason we've been MIA is because Ricky actually broke his fingers.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
At work, his two, the ring finger and the pinky finger. So I've been trying to doctor him back. Roxy, stop. No. Stop.
Eat. Give it to me. Give it to me. Go. Hurry up.
And other than his fingers are good now, but it was a long road trying to get his fingers back right. And then I actually started school to become a doctor, so we've been real busy. It's good?
Good. I just cleaned up my plate, yeah.
But, yeah, so probably in about 5 months, I'll have my PhD and I'm going to school for gynecology. It's been hard though. I've been like having to study all night long. Plus work, plus study, it's a lot. The onion is shriveled up. I shouldn't have put them in there. Oh, those haven't though.
How did you cut your mac and cheese?
You want me to cut it for you? You can use that. A little bit right here. Like that.
A little bigger.
Right here.
Yeah.
Look at that, y'all. Look at that steam coming off of it.
Looks good.
All right. Baby, you haven't ate my cornbread.
I'm about to grab some right now.
I'll cut you a little piece. He ain't my big bread eater. Like cornbread, stuff like that. Pour you a little bit. See? On what? Alright. Yeah, so just the studying, becoming a doctor, oh my gosh, I didn't even think it'll be as hard as it is, but the
macaroni. Yes, you put that sauce on that thing. It's good. No, I'm just saying, like, it's good. without it, but man, you put that sauce on it.
But what y'all been up to? Y'all got to definitely let us know what y'all been up to. We've been doing this lately, which you're not going to do today, but we do this whenever we eat dinner. It's good, isn't it, though?
Yeah, it really is. You know, it brings up the understanding of relationships, you know, getting to know right. each other. It's more like that deep conversation. Mm-hmm. Some relationships don't like to have that conversation, but, you know, with us, you know, it fits us, you know, just the question asking. Sometimes I don't like asking, being questions asked to me, but mm-hmm. on the dinner table, this is just, you know, our time to have like that family time and have that conversation. You know, we each pull a card, we read each other a question, mm-hmm. we answer it, and if we have response, you know, after I answer, then, you know, that's good. It's just like, you know, an open table, just have a conversation. So it's a good little personal.
Show them that plate.
It's a good little personal, you know, card game, I guess.
It is. It's like skin deep, so it really asks some tough questions or questions that you wouldn't necessarily think to ask, like your significant other. And, you know, you just get to know them on a more deeper level. Lunch tomorrow. I thought we was eating healthy on weekday.
I did say that.
But yeah, so some of the questions that we have were really good. One of them asked Ricky what he wanted to, where he saw himself in 10 years from now. And he mentioned that he wanted to be a pastor of a mega church. So.
Whosoever therefore shall be ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation of him.
What?
Why'd
you hit me?
I think not. I mean, I think she actually run her mouth on that. Nothing against being a pastor, nothing, you know. Some people just don't have, you know, that's not their field. I'm not saying it's not my field.
Why did you hit your leg?
That's probably not my calling that God's calling me, but, you know, God has another calling. God has another calling for me. So, ministry, you know, nothing against it. I am spiritual Christian, you know, love the Lord, all that. But as far as my path in 10 years, we really just never know. You know, whatever God has planned for me in 10 years, we'll just see how it goes.
So, one of the other questions was, like, what was a secret that you had in your past that, you know, we may not know about each other? And I basically revealed to Ricky that, you know, I used to be an exotic dancer.
Got the body of a goddess. Got eyes but a pink and brown. I see you, girl.
So, you know, that was kind
of
different.
A lot don't care who tells it, huh? An exotic dancer? Nothing against y'all, because, you know, you got to hustle, you got to grind, but that's not her. So, disregard that comment. Continue on, my love.
Yeah, so that's kind of like what we get up to. Those questions I really like them. One of the other really good questions was,
Have you eaten?
Is that hard?
Yeah.
No, that's too hard, yeah. One of the other questions was, where do you see yourself living in the next 5 to 10 years? And of course, you know, I was thinking like Houston or Birmingham or North Carolina. And it was kind of, I was surprised actually that Ricky mentioned that he wants to live in South Dakota.
We're both supposed
to. I'm like, I've never been to South Dakota. I've been to a lot of places, but I've never been there. So
I apologize, y'all. She is bad with us in South Dakota. I mean, I went to school in Minnesota, you know, the cold and all that kind of stuff. But No, I did not say that. So disregard that again, y'all. Continue on, my love.
But yeah. So that's really it though about the questions though. Is it good?
I wish I would put the sauce on the side instead of on the plate.
It was stuck to the chicken.
No, no, I know that.
You talking about taking it off?
No, I'm talking about when we bought it yesterday.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
I told them that, but they still did it.
They did it.
We're not about to do it right
now. No, I just wanted to answer one of these. You asked me. You don't have to answer any questions. I just want you to, just, you know.
I mean, you can just show the camera. So this
so
is
just waste a couple of time. I mean, just to, so we can get it like 4 or 5 more minutes so I won't see. You could just ask me this question. This was the first one up there. So this is basically how it goes. And we're going to do it like we really would do it if we were in our own space. Because that's really how I want to do those questions. I don't want to do it. You know what I'm saying? I mean, sometimes we may do it in front of the camera. But I like doing it in our own space. So, you know, we could just be authentic with each other.
All right. And the question goes, what does marriage mean to you?
Marriage to me is really just a piece of paper.
Okay, we could be cool, we in the same house. Hi.
It really doesn't mean, like you say, mean to me. It doesn't mean anything to me. It's just a piece of paper that you go to the courthouse and you sign, and it causes a lot of trouble or confusion when it's time to get a divorce, because now you're like bound by the whatever, you know, courthouse or state you decided to sign a piece of paper. I really wish people would get into the act of not thinking of marriage and just, you know, just being together and not thinking like, oh, we got to get married because, you know, or we have to have that piece of paper to solidify our relationship, because it really doesn't mean anything if you have that piece of paper or if you don't. So I really don't think marriage means anything to me. If you want to, if I could just say it in, you know, just being blunt about it, you know, marriage doesn't mean nothing to me. It's like, it's a waste of money at a wedding. It's now you got to figure out like, oh yeah, now I got to spend the rest of my life with this person. And it's like, what if, you know, 20 years from now you want to date somebody else, but now you're like married, so now you got to go and get rid of that piece of paper, and it's like, I don't want to be with you no more, but I'm married to you now. So marriage actually to me just doesn't mean anything. I don't believe in marriage. Like,
I mean, so that's her response.
Okay, time out. I've been pranking you.
You've been pranking me.
I just wanted to live the entire video to see how you would react.
Got him.
From the beginning, you knew I was lying?
Yeah. Cut you off on that.
No, I just
piece of paper, really? Right.
No, but what about all the other lies about me becoming a doctor and stuff? You didn't even say nothing.
Let you babble.
Well, what about you breaking your 2 fingers? You didn't even say nothing when I was saying that. You were just gonna let me think, let the people.
Brother, we're grabbing.
I'm just playing, y'all. I just tried to prank him and tell lies. But marriage means everything to me. It is more than just a piece of paper. It's really, like, marriage for me is a 100% commitment. It's not always going to be easy. And I can promise you, if you've ever met a married couple that said they have not had any disagreements, no ups and downs in the relationships and stuff like that, then you haven't met a real married couple. You know what I'm saying? Like, because marriage isn't easy, but it's worth it. You know, at the end of the day, you're going to have disagreements. Like, him and I, we have disagreements. It'd be very petty disagreements, but we have disagreements. But at the end of the day, because we're married, but because we have respect and we are actually in love with each other, like, it surpasses everything. And plus, Ricky's the type of person that if he's 100% mad because I done got angry about something and I look at him and smile, he's gonna smile no matter how angry he is. Mm-hmm. Huh? What happened? No matter how angry he is, he's just gonna look at me and he's gonna try not to smile, but his lips gonna be like, because he's gonna be trying to hold it in because he can't be mad at me for long. So, no, marriage is everything, and I feel like it's a life commitment with the person that you love. And when people say, like, oh, yeah, they know people that's died from heartbreaks after, like, if your husband died and then 2 weeks later you die, and it's like you died from heartbreak. Like, I honestly feel like that would be me. I couldn't imagine life without Ricky. Like, I couldn't imagine life, like, him not being in my life, whether he's alive or not alive. Like, wherever he's at, I want to be. When he goes to heaven, I want to be in heaven. Him here on earth, wherever he's at, I'm going with him. I'm down for whatever. Like, if he really said he wanted to move to South Dakota, guess what? We moving to South Dakota because I would not let him move by himself, because I just can't imagine myself being long periods of time without him. Like, my heart would be broken because I just need, even if we be in the house, like, so we be in separate rooms, like, he'd be playing his game in his little man cave room, and then I'd be, you know, in our room or whatever, just relaxing or whatever, I still know he's right there, you know what I'm saying? So if I need to feel him or talk to him or anything like that, he's right there. Like, I know where he's at. But yeah, marriage is everything, and I feel like God led me to the right life partner, and I'm happy, and I love you.
I love you too, baby. Marriage to me will mean just one, unity. You say I do, you know. It means I do every, I do. I'm with you for the rest of my life. We took the oath, said I do. I mean, for better, for worse, through rich and poor, through thick and thin.
Thick and thin. Let them know.
Through thick and thin, you know, we're stuck together. And the love just keeps burning. So, I love my baby. She loves me. We in this together forever. And
forever and ever.
We're one.
Gang, gang.
You know, we just equal as one, so. Once you say I do, she say I do, we're complete.
Yeah. And no matter how you say I do, no matter if it's a courthouse, no matter if it's a huge wedding, no matter if it's just a couple of people, you know, take it serious.
Right.
You know, sometimes, and I'm going to just be honest, because when I first said I do, because it wasn't the way that, like the fairy tale, it kind of felt like just another day. You know what I'm saying? Because it was like we were already committed to each other.
Right.
So, like, having, saying, oh, like, this is my husband, I'm his wife. It took me a while to get to the point of saying, like, I got a different type of lifestyle I gotta walk now because this is my husband. And that commitment is real. You know what I'm saying? So, sometimes it just don't click like that at the beginning once you say I do, because it just feels like, okay, another day. But then eventually you get to the point of saying, like, wait, you know, when you read the Bible and it says how a husband's supposed to be, how a wife is supposed to be, and you gain that knowledge and you like, okay, yeah, I've been doing it wrong. Like, I've been being a husband the wrong way. I've been being a wife the wrong way. Like, I need to take serious those vows that I said and be a wife. And it took me a while, and I'm just going to be honest with it. Like, it took me a while to say, I'm not just his girl. You know what I'm saying? I'm his wife. And there are duties that I have to, you know what I'm saying, like, abide by. So, like, at the beginning when you first get married, it's going to be a little rocky because y'all trying to figure it out.
Right.
And you trying to be like, okay, yeah, like, you, it doesn't, sometimes it don't click right away when you say I do. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. But, you know, you're going to figure each other out. You're going to learn something new about each other every single day, no matter if you're together for 30 days or 30 years. So, yeah, that's basically how we kind of talk when we do the and. You full, boo?
Yeah, I'm not full, but I'm good.
I am. I'm full. You know I'm full. But was the cornbread good?
Yeah. Let me get another piece of that.
Yeah, but
it's that corn.
Anyways, y'all, we gonna make sure that I decided, like, I don't want, like, Boo wanted to do the mukbang thing or whatever, and, like, I'm cool with that. And sometimes we may just, like, sit down and talk or whatever. I may have, some food or something like that. But I don't really want to do mukbangs because I'm not just going to be sitting up there eating. So I just prefer to do, like, vlogs, like, when we vacation or if we doing something or whatever.
Right.
So we'll probably be doing more vlogs than sitting down and eating. But, and pranks.
Right. So once again, make sure y'all like, subscribe, push that like button, comment, and
hit the bell.
Hit that bell. Ding, 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 ding.
So you can be notified every time we upload because we comment in 2022. You feel me?
We're on the way. So once again, we appreciate y'all for tuning in. We are the Raphaels. Raphael out.
No, you didn't do it right. Raphael out.